And welcome to a very special edition of the Stakelbeck on Terror show from the 7th annual Christians United for Israel Summit in Washington, D.C. You know, I've been coming here all 7 years, and every year it's getting better and better. Bigger crowds, bigger speakers, an even stronger message. And in those 7 years, CUFI has grown to become the largest pro-Israel organization in the world. It's been an incredible period of growth for CUFI. I don't think that's a coincidence. You're going to love what you see on the show this week. The message is, look, the time is now. It's never been more important for supporters of Israel to step up, stand up, and be counted. So fasten your seatbelt. A lot coming to you this week from the Christians United for Israel Summit. But first, my sit-down with Pastor John Hagee, the founder of CUFI. Take a look. Well, Pastor Hagee, welcome to Stakelbeck on Terror.
I'm delighted to be here. Thank you for having me.
Always a pleasure to have you. And, you know, I'm here at the CUFI Summit, the annual CUFI Summit, the seventh one that I've attended. And, Pastor, to see how the organization has grown by leaps and bounds, this is a huge production in a great way, in a beautiful way here at the Washington Convention Center. When you started the group in 2006, there's now over 1 million members, largest pro-Israel organization in America. Did you ever picture it coming this far, this fast?
No way. There's no way we could have possibly foreseen the miraculous growth we have. Right now, we have 1.2 million active email partners who respond to our rapid response to any person, whether it's president, senator, congressman, mayor, whatever, that relates to Israel on any issue.
Yeah, I really, Pastor, I think CUFI is kind of the ultimate grassroots organization. And as you said, the power of the grassroots. But you also have a lot of influence here on Capitol Hill, a positive influence. You're getting in lawmakers' ears. Is that one of the aims of CUFI, to really make your presence felt in the nation's capital, too, with decision makers, look, who are kind of setting the agenda with Israel? The direction it's been going in the last few years, not so great, but one of your missions, I would think, is to affect the discourse on Israel here in Capitol Hill.
Absolutely. One of our goals is to bring representatives from every state in the union to Washington, D.C., to meet with their senators and to meet with their congressmen, and to have specific talking points about issues that are relevant to Israel at that point in time. We want them to know that there is a strong voter base of people who are pro-Israel, and we are watching how they respond to the issues that affect Israel.
But Pastor, it seems like a lot of Americans, even who might not have the level of knowledge about the issues as the average CUFI member, instinctively in their gut support Israel. Talk about, and I think that's so big for CUFI, that instinctive American support. Talk about the long-standing relationship between the American people and the state of Israel, kind of a love affair in many ways.
The American people have been people who are readers of the Bible. They believe the Bible. The Bible is a Zionist text. It begins in Genesis 1 and 1 with God created the heavens and the earth. And as owner of the earth, he went to a man named Abraham and made a covenant with him that he was going to give him a piece of specific real estate on the edge of the Mediterranean Sea, and it would belong to the Jewish people forever. It was made in a blood covenant. God says in the Bible that I am the Lord that never breaks covenant. I keep covenant for 50 generations. Technically, that's 50,000 years, but it means literally then forever. So God has given the land to the Jewish people. The Jewish people are not possessing something that belongs to someone else, as they say, occupying the land. They own the land. God gave it to them. It belongs to them.
Yeah. You know, Pastor, the American people, poll after poll, shows overwhelmingly support Israel. That's without question. Over the past few years with the Obama administration, we've seen some daylight, I guess it could be described as, between the administration, the Israelis. With your position at CUFI, I guess that makes CUFI's mission even more important right now. When we are seeing some tension in the relationship, at least at the governmental level, do you feel that CUFI has even maybe a more of a special responsibility
to kind of fill that void and help to keep the relationship strong.
It's for sure that there is daylight between the American government and Israel. And in this administration, that has become apparent. And any time that your friend, in this case, the Jewish people in Israel, are being offended or being pushed aside, it makes your role as defender much more critical and much more necessary. The actions of this administration have done nothing but motivate the American people to speak out in support of Israel. The last Gallup poll said that 63% of the American people support Israel. It also said that 17% of the American people support Congress. That means Israel is about five times as popular as the U.S. Congress.
Look, Iran is very close to acquiring a nuclear weapon. Everyone agrees on that. How concerned are you about this Iranian threat? How much does this loom large in your thinking?
It is a very critical issue. It, in my opinion, is the number one foreign policy issue for the United States of America. If Iran gets a nuclear weapon, it will restructure the Middle East. It will give Iran the canopy under which they can distribute weapons of mass destruction to terrorist organizations all over the world, including those who are already in America. Iran has said that they will use this against Israel. They are promising they will use it. And if history teaches us anything, it's when a dictator promises to kill you, take him seriously. No one took Hitler seriously, and 6 million Jews died. We have a maniac in Ahmadinejad who believes that the only way he can get to heaven is to die fighting Christians or Jews, and that if he creates chaos, his Messiah will show up. You can certainly create chaos with a nuclear weapon in the world. That's their objective, and they're not going to stop until they get it. And the efforts of the United States government to stop them have been very limp-wristed and ineffectively administered.
Pastor, what do you think of the so-called Arab Spring? I'm based here in Washington, D.C. We were talking before the interview, and there was a lot of joy, even among conservatives here inside the Beltway. They thought the Arab Spring was a great thing, the dawn of democracy in the Middle East. What are your thoughts on the effects of the Arab Spring in places like Egypt on Israel and America's security?
Well, the Muslim Brotherhood has already said that they're going to disregard the peace treaty that existed between Egypt and Israel under Mubarak. So whenever the Arab Spring happened, I said, as it was happening, when this is over, you will see the Muslim Brotherhood in control, because they have been there for decades. They're highly funded. They're well organized. They have specific goals. They will run the nation of Egypt, and it will be anti-Semitic, anti-American, and anti-Israel. It won't be anti-American initially, because they want to milk us for all of the foreign aid they can get. But when they feel like they've gotten all they're going to get out of us, they will turn both on us and Israel.
I have to ask you, tell us about your new book.
I've written a new book. It's called The Power of the Prophetic Blessing. This is a book that demonstrates to the believer how that they have the ability to receive and to release the power of the prophetic blessing that's demonstrated in the scripture. Whenever God created Adam and Eve, the Bible says that God breathed into him the breath of life. That word breathed is the Hebrew word ruach, which means spirit. That you literally have the divine and supernatural power of speech. Whenever God began to form a new nation, he blessed Abraham. Whenever Jesus breathed on his disciples, they received the Holy Spirit. The Bible says the power of life and death is in the speech. This book was born years ago when I went to a Jewish bar mitzvah and saw a Jewish father put his hands on the heads of his children and pray a blessing over them. And I listened to that blessing, and a light came on in my mind. Why is it that century after century, The Jewish people have been so blessed. Their children have succeeded so famously. I believe it's because of the power of the prophetic blessing. Their fathers for generations have put their hands on the heads of their children, and they have spoken a prophetic blessing over the lives of their sons and daughters and have empowered them to go out and accomplish exploits that other generations have not had. This is releasing a mystery to the Christian church that has been practiced in Judaism for 2,000 years or longer. And I demonstrate how biblical and how effective it is. Once I taught this to my church, it revolutionized the relationships between parents and children. It revolutionized the relationship in marriages. Children who were not doing well in school suddenly began to do well. Their self-esteem exploded. Good things began to happen because the father became the priest of the house and began to release that blessing on his children and grandchildren.
Well, Pastor Hagee, thank you so much. You're a true watchman on the wall, a mighty man of God. You inspire us all in this pro-Israel movement, so thank you so much. Always thank great you. Sitting with you.
John Mapes is 42, mortgage, married, two great kids. He wants to protect his family with a $500,000 term life insurance policy. What do you think it'll cost him? $100 a month? $60? $40? Actually, none of the above. John can get a $500,000 policy from a highly rated insurer for under $25 a month. His secret? SelectQuote. SelectQuote is impartial. They'll search the pick of insurers like these to give you a choice of your best prices. SelectQuote has great savings on term life for women, too. John's wife, Carrie, can get a $500,000 policy for under $16 a month. SelectQuote has helped make term life insurance affordable for hundreds of thousands of people since 1985. How about you? Just call this number or visit SelectQuote.com.
If you have diabetes and you're on Medicare, call now for a new pain-free meter. These new meters are more accurate, they're easier to use, and the best news is you don't have to prick your fingers anymore. Call now, and Arriva Medical will send you one of these new meters for free. And if you have Medicare, your testing supplies may also be covered. Arriva makes it simple. They bill Medicare directly. There are no upfront costs. And they deliver your supplies right to your door for free. With these new meters, there's no coding. You don't have to prick your fingers. And some of these meters even talk.
Your blood glucose reading is 122.
And if you call 1-800-284-9762, we will send you a free Betty Crocker Diabetes Cookbook filled with delicious recipes.
Call Arriva today. You'd be glad you did.
Well, we also had a chance to sit down with the executive director of CUFI, David Brog. David is a good friend of this show. He's the author of In Defense of Faith and one of the real seminal works in this movement. It's called Standing with Israel, both must reads. And as you'll see, David is one of the most eloquent speakers and spokesmen for the pro-Israel movement. Check it out.
I think Americans in general, and American Christians in particular, in this post 9/11 world are aware that the greatest security threat to America still comes from militant Islam, be it Al-Qaeda, Iran, Hezbollah, Hamas. When you understand militant Islam is a great threat to America, then it's very easy to see a strong Israel as a great asset to America. Israel is on the front lines fighting our shared enemies for us. So it's no surprise to me to see Americans supporting Israel at a higher level than ever before. And it's no surprise to me that Christians in particular, who have a biblical worldview, who understand there is such a thing as evil in the world, and evil today we can see in the actions of militant Islam, Islamic terror. It's no surprise to me that they understand the need for a strong and secure Israel. Not only is it the right thing to do biblically, it's our first line of defense in the West. I had a conversation last week with someone who has been involved in pro-Israel work for probably two decades. She's been on the Hill for decades representing the pro-Israel Jewish community. And she said to me, since CUFI was founded, everything has changed on the Hill. She said, I have more and more congressmen with no Jews in their district seeking me out, saying, I want to do the right thing for the U.S.-Israel relationship. Otherwise, I'm going to be in trouble with my Christian constituents. And she gave us credit for effecting this change as an organization that doesn't endorse, as an organization that tries to educate our leaders. We have admitted, and we do admit, we have been disappointed in this administration. And without getting into all the policy decisions which I believe were mistaken, I'll just give a theme. It seems to me that this administration views Israel as the problem. If asked the question, why is there no peace in the Middle East? I think they would answer, Israel's the problem. And because of that mistaken thesis, it's led to mistaken policy and inappropriate pressure. It does raise a concern. Will we see that pressure again? Will we see that mistaken premise guiding our policy down the road? It's our job to work to educate our leaders that the opposite is true. If it was all about Israel leaving the West Bank and Gaza and allowing a Palestinian state, if that would bring peace, there would have been peace back in 1937, back in 1948, back in 1967, back in 2000, back in 2008. Every time Israel's offered to do exactly that, and the other side has turned it down, I'd argue the real problem, what is driving this conflict, is the refusal of the Arabs to recognize and live in peace with a Jewish state of any size, shape, or form anywhere in the Middle East. That's why they turned down every offer to create a Palestinian state. That's why they've turned down every offer to divide the land. If you view the conflict through that lens, I think you'll end up pursuing far more productive policies, not only for Israel, but for peace.
Dear Bowflex, I dropped 8 dress sizes, 36 pounds, and all I had to do was walk.
This is the Bowflex Trek Climber Machine, the easiest way to walk and burn up to 3.5 times the calories. By combining the motion of a treadmill, a stepper, and an elliptical, you get the calorie burning benefits of all 3 workouts at once.
I lost 30 pounds in 4 months. If I can do it, anyone can do it.
Call now for your free DVD and information kit. You'll see how the Trek Climber burns up to 3.5 times the calories of a treadmill. Right now, you can own a Trek Climber machine today and get special financing for 18 months.
Within the first couple of weeks, I started to lose inches. I lost 50 pounds in 3 months using the Trek Climber.
I lost 150 pounds in such a short period of time. All my friends are like, how did you do it?
To look better and feel younger, call or go online to buytc.com for your free DVD and information kit today.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Bowflex.
Sincerely, J.D. Weber.
Friends, Pat Boone here with an important message from Swiss America. The world's money system is very unstable now, sending the price of food, gasoline, education, health care, almost everything, higher and higher. You know, I can remember when a cup of coffee was just 5 cents. You remember that, don't you? Today, it costs $5 for the same cup of coffee. I also remember when $20 could buy this ounce of gold. Today, it costs nearly 100 times more for the same ounce of gold. Some say gold is an ancient relic, too old-fashioned to be money anymore. Well, guess what? Now it's paper money that's seen better days. So don't put your family or your future in jeopardy. Convert your paper into gold. Call the professionals, my trusted friends at Swiss America, while you still have time. Protect your standard of living from a rising cost of living with a gold standard.
And welcome back. You know, I'm honored every year to speak at the CUFI Summit about the threats that America and Israel are facing. And this year in particular was very special for me. I was a part of the Middle East briefing, joined by Senator Joe Lieberman, Ari Fleischer, former spokesman for President George W. Bush, and Malcolm Hohenlein, who has for years been one of the top voices in support of Israel here in America. So here's a clip from my speech. Check it out.
People tell me all the time, Iran is just a threat to Israel. Iran is over there, we're over here. Ladies and gentlemen, don't let them fool you. In the Iranian ideology, in their eschatology, Israel is only the little savior. It's America that is the great savior. Their words, not mine. We are the ultimate prize in Iran's eyes. Israel is just a bump on the road, on their way to us. You know, there's a reason that in 2010, strangely enough, very underreported once again, our own Pentagon released a briefing. In that briefing, it said that by 2015, 3 years from now, Iran may very well have new intercontinental ballistic missiles, ICBMs, capable of reaching the east coast of the United States, where you're sitting right now. And if things continue as they've been going, those ICBMs will be nuclear tipped. That's our Pentagon. That's 2015. Do I have your attention? In April, during Easter week, of all weeks, a delegation from Egypt's Muslim Brotherhood was at the White House. How nice. I refer to the Muslim Brotherhood, and forgive me if this is hyperbole, but I call them, and I think it's an accurate description, terrorists in suits. And you can see why our naive, liberal, Western journalists are fooled, are hoodwinked. You can see why this administration is fooled, is hoodwinked. The Muslim Brotherhood doesn't come to you in the guise of Al-Qaeda. They don't have a flowing robe of beard down to their bellies. They're not screaming about jihad publicly most of the time. Al-Qaeda wants to kill you now, blow you up now. They want the caliphate now. The Brotherhood says, guys, look. This is like a 50 to 100 year plan. Be patient. We don't need to do this now through violent jihad. We can do it through elections. Have you seen the election results recently in the Middle East and North Africa? Score one for the Brotherhood strategy. We can do it through elections. We can get jobs in the government, the media, sensitive positions, academia. This is a strategy of gradualism and infiltration and stealth jihad. And for my money, it's 1,000 times more effective than Al-Qaeda's any day. And proof of that, they're in the White House. On your walls, O Jerusalem, I have set watchmen day and night who will never hold their peace. And ladies and gentlemen, that's a key part of that verse. Never hold your peace. Speak out. Be bold. There's no time to mince words. It's only Western Central civilization at stake. In the state of Israel, in the United States at stake. Ezekiel says, if the watchmen do not sound the alarm, God says to Ezekiel, I will hold the watchmen accountable. Be held accountable in that way. I'm going to speak out. I'm going to do so boldly and without fear because I remember Psalm 91. God still gives angels shards over you in the most difficult situations. If God is with us, who can stand against us?
When it's warm, you'd love to open every door and let fresh air into your home. The trouble is, you'd end up letting lots of bugs into your home as well. Now there's Magic Mesh, the new type of screen door that opens easily and then magically closes itself behind you. The secret isn't really magic, it's magnets, 18 magnets to be exact. When you separate them, they automatically snap back together. That makes it great for pets too, because instead of scratching and whining, they can come and go as they please. So let the fresh air in and keep those annoying bugs out with Magic Mesh, a $40 value, yours for just $19.95. But wait, call right now and we'll double the offer. Just pay separate processing and handling. You get two Magic Mesh curtains for just $19.95. Don't delay. Call and order yours today.
To order Magic Mesh for $19.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-270-5583 or log on to buymagicmesh.com.
The sun used to make our outdoor deck and patio space so hot and uncomfortable, we couldn't use it.
But then we discovered the Sunsetter Retractable Awning. Our Sunsetter Retractable Awning opens and closes in just 60 seconds. It keeps our patio about 20 degrees cooler.
It provides instant shade and instant protection from the sun's harmful rays.
And our Sunsetter costs under $700.
But now you can get your Sunsetter
for as little as $499.
When you call now to get this special $200 discount certificate and free awning idea kit.
We love our Sunsetter Retractable Awning, and you're going to love yours too.
Sunsetter awnings are assembled in America and guaranteed to last for years. So call now to get this free awning idea kit with DVD, plus your $200 Sunsetter discount certificate.
But this is a limited time offer.
Call now.
Call now for your free awning idea kit with DVD and $200 discount certificate. There's no obligation.
1-800-913-7523.
And welcome back. We're wrapping up here at the 7th Annual Christians United for Israel Summit in Washington, D.C. You know, the Bible says, and I say it on this show a lot of times because it bears repeating, my people perish for lack of knowledge. That's what this summit is all about. At the end of the day, CUFI is all about educating the American people and the world about the threats Israel and America face together and why it is so important, so vital, for Christians to stand with the land and the people of Israel. You know, the book of Isaiah chapter 62 says, on your walls, O Jerusalem, I have set watchmen day and night who will never hold their peace. That's the theme here at CUFI. Never hold your peace when it comes to standing up for God's land and God's people. I know I'm not gonna. I'm going to be here standing for Israel until my dying day, and I hope you will be too, and I hope you'll be tuning into this show each week as we bring you the truth. So from the 7th Annual CUFI Summit, take care, God bless, and see you next week.
Be sure to pick up my book, The Terrorist Next Door, How the Government is Deceiving You About the Islamist Threat. Available wherever books are sold from coast to coast.